Good morning, kids, and welcome back to this week's kids video. My name is Caitlin, and I hope you're doing well. This term, we are going to be studying the book of Proverbs. I've got a hat here filled with a whole bunch of facts about the book of Proverbs. You guys ready? Let's see what's first. Ooh, the book of Proverbs is in the Old Testament. So if you're looking for it, you can find it in the Old Testament's part of your Bible. See what else there is? It's part of the wisdom genre. So books like Job, Ecclesiastes, and Proverbs, all in the same genre. And fun fact, your parents are going to be studying the book of Ecclesiastes in church and in their Bible studies. See what's next? There are 31 chapters in Proverbs. How interesting is that? You could read chapter each day and then be finished by the end of the month. Maybe not February, but you could try. It's a collection of sayings. Okay, so it's not a story. Good to know, good to know. It's filled with principles, not promises. Come back for next week for that. That's a good one. See what's next. All sticking together. Ugh. The main topic is wisdom, and the opposite of wisdom is folly. We've got wisdom and folly. Interesting. Ooh, this one's a cool one. The book of Proverbs was mainly written by King Solomon. And we know King Solomon from our series last year, from our lessons last year, because Solomon was a wise king. That's right. Well, that's the end of the hat. But like every book in the Bible, Proverbs is written for a reason. And that reason is so that we can know how to be wise in God's world. But now, there is a difference between clever and being wise. Now, I've got a kettle here to help us figure that out. Now, you can be so clever to know that water boils at 100 degrees. That's right. But wisdom is not putting your hand in to feel the boiling water because you know that you'll get burnt. Wisdom helps us to make good choices in life. In the book of Proverbs, which teaches us how to be wise, some of the sayings are said by Lady Wisdom. Now, let me introduce you to a friend of mine who is also wise like Lady Wisdom, Lady Fantasia. And Lady Fantasia is going to tell us a story today.
Hello, I'm Lady Fantasia. And being wise is knowing what to say and do in every situation. It's knowing what God wants us to say and do. In our Bible, in the book of Proverbs, chapter 1, verse 7, it tells us that the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord. Fearing God, how can that make us wise? I'm going to tell you a story about a boy who had to cross a highway, and it's going to help you to understand. So listen closely now. Johnny was in a hurry. He had to get to soccer practice and he was late. He took a shortcut through the park, up Cooper Street, until he reached the busy highway. A three-lane highway his mother had told him never, ever to cross. But Johnny was late, and this was the quickest way to the club. He knew his coach would already be making the team warm up, and he hated being late. So Johnny looked to his right. Cars and trucks and vans were traveling at a high speed down the highway. He waited and waited and waited until finally there was a break in the traffic. Quickly, Johnny began to walk across the first lane, but just as he did, an enormous truck came flying down the highway, honking madly. Johnny ran back to the side of the road. His heart was pounding. Where did that truck come from? Again, Johnny looked to his right. Cars and trucks and vans were traveling at high speed down the highway. Again he waited and waited and waited until finally there was a break in the traffic. Quickly, Johnny began to walk across the first lane and then the second lane. But as he reached the second lane, a red sports car slammed on its brakes and craned to a screeching stop. Johnny could tell the man was not happy, and he ran back to the side of the road. His heart was pounding. Where did that sports car come from? Again, Johnny looked to his right. Cars and trucks and vans were traveling at high speed down the highway. He waited and waited and waited until finally there was a break in the traffic. Quickly, Johnny began to walk across the first lane, the second lane, but as he was crossing the third lane, a man put his head out the window of his car and yelled at him. Johnny ran back across lane three, across lane two, across lane one. He slumped on the ground. His heart felt like it was going to pound right out of his chest. Just then, a man stopped and smiled down at Johnny. He pointed down the road. Johnny looked in the direction the man was pointing and he saw a footbridge. A bridge that went up and right over the three-lane highway. Johnny thanked the man and he walked down to the footbridge. His mother was right. Never, ever try and cross a three-lane highway. He would use that footbridge from now on.
Did you spot what Lady Fantasia read from Proverbs about wisdom? Wisdom starts by fearing the Lord. Now in the Bible, there are two different types of fears. The one that we all know, fear when it comes to being afraid of something. Like when God's people had just received the Ten Commandments and Moses read out all the rules, the people were afraid that God would judge them. And the Bible says in Exodus 20 verse 18, the people heard the thunder and the trumpets. They saw the lightning on the mountain and the smoke rising from the mountain. They shook with fear and stood far away from the mountain. Now that's the first type of fear, but the second is the meaning in Proverbs. And that fear is when you respect and stand in awe of God. So fearing God is not only being scared of Him, but rather respecting Him and standing in amazement of Him. Now, why respecting? Well, because God deserves it. Because He made everything. He rules everything. It is standing back and going, wow, this is the Lord God. I want to love Him. I want to do what He says. And God's people actually did this in the book of Exodus as well, just after they escaped. They came to the Red Sea and they were trapped because the Egyptian army was chasing them down. But what did God do? He opened the Red Sea and split it down the middle so that they could walk through on dry ground. God's people responded by fearing God. Let's see in Exodus. When the people of Israel saw the great power that the Lord had used against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and they trusted the Lord and His servant Moses. After seeing how amazing God is, they stood back and went, wow. I want to follow Him. I want to fear Him. In the story that Lady Fantasia told, did you spot that Johnny did not fear his mom? He didn't respect her. And we could see that when he didn't listen to what she had said about crossing the large and very dangerous and very busy highway. Johnny should have feared and respected his mom. It would have helped him to cross the road by the huge bridge. In a similar way, when we fear God, we will know how to be wise for living in God's world. Fearing God is the first step to being wise, because when we fear God, we realize how amazing He is and stand back and go, wow. And when we know how amazing He is, we want to respect Him and do what He says. For the rest of Proverbs and learning about wise life that God wants us to live, we need to remember where it all begins. and it begins with fearing God. Now, here are some questions for you and your family. And this is a chance for you to show us what you have understood. And this is the bit that matters most. So why is it right to fear and respect your mom, dad, or teacher? How is God different to us? And why is it good to fear him? Proverbs 1 verse 7. Can you look at that verse and ask, how can you become a wise child? How can you get to know more about God this week so that you can start to fear him properly? And what is one thing about God that you can remember this week to help you fear him? And then afterwards, as a family, you can pray together and you can do a popcorn prayer. Now, these are prayers that are quick one-liners that go pop, and you can each think of one thing from today's video or story to say please or thank you for. Now, I'm just gonna pray. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for making this world and us. And thank you for being in control of this world and us. Help us to learn how to respect and love you. Amen.